Hi everyone, and welcome to lesson number 20. My name is Michael Geddes. In lesson number 19, I introduced step number one of how to sing and strum a song at the same time. The pop song we're working on is a song called Who Stopped the Rain by Creedence Clearwater. I want you to keep on going back to that lesson 19 and practicing with that chart. Follow my directions very closely, okay? You'll understand why that's so important when I introduce step number three in the next lesson. This is step number two. In step number two, I'm going to show you a very simple approach in how to begin to strum and sing at the same time. So it's very important that you keep on listening to the song and singing with the song, feeling the rhythm of the song and the lyrics of feel the rhythm of the lyrics as well. So let me move on to the next clip and I'll begin to show you how to do that. So hopefully you know the chord chart to Who Stopped the Rain. That was the chart in lesson number 19 that you really need to be practicing. So if you've been studying that, you know there's an introduction to the song and there's three verses of the song. This clip, we're going to work on verse number one. The next clip, we're going to work on verse number two. And the clip after that, verse number three. So the introduction, you're going to strum just like you practiced in lesson number 19. Four strums on each chord. When you get to the first verse, or any of the verses, you're going to play that chord that you see above the lyric one time. Keep singing. When you come to the next lyric, when you see the chord above that lyric, change to that chord. Keep singing and move on. So let me demonstrate that, and I'm going to begin with the introduction. Long as I remember, the rain's been coming down. Clouds of mystery pouring, confusion on the ground. Good men through the ages, trying to find the sun. And I wonder, stop the video and practice that for a little bit, and we'll move on to the next verse in the next clip. So, the second verse, you're going to do the same routine, okay? Play the chord above the lyric when you come to it, and then move on. Here we go. I went down Virginia, seeking shelter from the storm. Caught up in the fable, I watched the tower grow. 5-year plans and new deals, wrapped in golden chains. And I wonder, still I wonder, who'll stop the rain? Now you can do your two G's. Now would be the time that you were playing the bridge, but we're going to skip that for now because we're just talking about singing and strumming at the same time. So let's move on to the next clip and we'll practice verse number three. So let's work on verse number three. Heard the singers playing, how we cheered for more. The crowd had rushed together, trying to keep warm. Still the rain kept falling, falling on my head. And I wonder, still I wonder, who'll stop the rain? And you two G's. Now, I've been doing this for a long time, so getting the chord changes for me is not a big issue. But for those of you who are just starting out, it is a big issue, and I totally understand that. So your process may need to look something more like this. Get your G chord, start maybe sing a little bit slower. Heard the singers playing. Now take your time, get the C chord. How I cheered for. Take a little breath, a little pause, get that G chord. More. The crowd had rushed together, trying to keep warm. Okay, so take your time to get those chords. You can't get them any faster than you're ready to get them. Now, I've got some great lessons that I'll introduce in upcoming lessons that'll help you really begin to get those chords quicker. But even with every exercise in the world, it's just a matter of time until you can really start to get those chords without pausing. So this concludes lesson number 20. Keep on practicing what I taught you today. Changing the chord and strumming the chord once, when you're singing the song, you come to the lyric, you're gonna strum that chord once, and then move on with your singing, okay? And when you see the chord come up again above the lyric you're on, strum that chord once. So that's step number two, what we went over today. Keep on practicing step number one, because in step number three, the next lesson, I'm going to teach you a more complicated strum. Well, that more complicated strum is exactly the same thing you're practicing in lesson number 19. But you'll be singing with that quite comfortably with the more complicated strum when we get to that point. Please like and subscribe to my channel today, if you would, if you haven't already. My name is Michael Geddes. I look forward to seeing you at lesson number 21, and thanks for being here today.